Hey, what's up guys, it's Renaldo here. So this video is going to focus on our self-professed weak president. Yeah, that's right. Cyril Ramaphosa has labeled himself as a weak president. Now, if you don't believe me, take a look at the following video.
And I said I would rather be seen as the weak president than to split the ANC. Because that is not my mission. My mission is to keep the ANC united.
Yeah, so that video is from 2018 when he became the president of South Africa. So that's the context. But what is true is that he is a weak president. He is known as Spineless Cyril, after all. We saw what has happened during the lockdown. He relies on other people to tell him what to do. He can't take decisions himself. And it goes back to something so insignificant as his Twitter profile, in which he clearly states, first and foremost, that he's the president of the African National Congress, and then that he's the president of the country. Now, that is insulting. I don't care how you try and explain it away or try and say that, you know, he is a product of the ANC. When you get elected as the president of South Africa, you represent every single person of South Africa. And thus, you are the representative of South Africa. You are citizen number one. And if in that moment you still decide that you want to put the people of the ANC above other citizens of this country, then it shows what an absolute failure of a human being you are. Now, this trend isn't something that's new. Cyril Ramaphosa is used to failure. The only reason that he's a billionaire is because he was handed all his shares. He was handed the shares in the mining industry. He was handed the shares to McDonald's. So he has never built anything from the ground up. Cyril Ramaphosa is a billionaire because of broad-based black economic empowerment. No matter how you slice it, Cyril Ramaphosa is a failure. And yes, it's really hard to explain how a multi-billionaire is a failure. But if you have the context of where he got the money, how he got the money, then you can understand, okay, yes, he's a billionaire, but he's still an absolute failure. He is a failure as a businessman. He's a failure in as a minister and as a deputy president, you know, Marikana as an example. The fact that he was put in charge of state-owned enterprises, Eskom, the post office, SAA. Where are all of them right now? How are they doing? How is SAA doing? Do we still have rolling blackouts now? Yes. Would you send anything with the post office? Hell no. But every single thing that Cyril Ramaphosa has touched has turned to shit. And the latest example of this is South Africa. Here we are in a lockdown that has now gone close to 150 days. And our economy is on the brink of collapse. Unemployment is the highest it's ever been. Crime rates are the highest that it's ever been. And yet we have a president that is still adamant that it's party before the country. And if people are wondering, I wonder why South Africa is doing so terribly. I wonder why this country is a shithole at the moment. Well, you don't need to look any further than the president and then the African National Congress. Because the two will not separate each other from one another. It's a case of, well, I'm the president of the country, but I am loyal to the ANC. We saw that with Cyril Ramaphosa. We saw that with Jacob Zuma. We saw that with Thabo Mbeki. The only president that actually broke away from that was Nelson Mandela. And I mean, that is 22 years ago. So for the last 22 years, we've had presidents that put the party before the country. And you can see what has happened to this country because of that. And also, as I've explained in previous videos, we've got a racist president. We've got a president that, when he says our people, clearly refers to black individuals. He said it as much. It's not me speculating. He has said in his addresses, our people, black people. And I just don't understand how you can respect somebody that belittles and insults you in that manner. Mr. President, I am a citizen of this country. I'm a South African. I consider myself an African. Am I not one of your people just because of the color of my skin? Is that how idiotically narrow-minded you are when you want to talk about the citizens of this country? Is that really how pathetic you are? Because it does seem that you are that narrow-minded by making the speeches that you do, by bringing up apartheid, by bringing up colonialism, by talking about a racist economy that you and your party have been in charge of for the last 26 years. It seems that you want to blame everybody else but you and your organization for failing South Africa. And you are so desperate that you know that you are failing, but you want to blame other people for your own mistakes. When you yourself have said that you put the party ahead of the country. And that is what's wrong with South Africa. You and your organization that is failing this country, and you would rather let this country burn than to split the ANC. And that is the current state of South Africa. So to end off this video, if in 2020 you still have to ask yourself why South Africa is in the state it's in, then I'm starting to suspect that you might actually have brain damage. Because it's quite clear that our president is only there to represent people that are loyal to the ANC. He doesn't even consider you a South African if your pigmentation is different to his. And he has said as much. He said as much, and the ANC has said as much. Time and time again, the ANC has demonstrated that they do not give a shit about you if you are not a black individual. And if you can't grasp that, even today, after all the things that the president and the ANC has said, then the problem lies with you. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by clicking the join button below. Also, go and check out techclothing.com. If you see something there that you like, then please be sure to buy it. Also, please be sure to subscribe. And if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so that you can be notified of my future uploads. Be sure to drop a comment. Be sure to smash that like button. And also, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.
You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre. I wear my massacre. You don't even know me, but every time you see me, you say, I wear my massacre. I wear my massacre.